뭐 부탁하셨으나.
So now what are those things which invalidate a person's prayer?
الكلام العمد مع العلم والذكر.
A person speaking intentionally and he knows and he remembers.
يعني تكلم في الصلاة.
As an example, somebody speaks in the prayer
وهو ذاكر لا ناسي.
And he isn't forgetful, he knows what he's doing.
عالما بتحريم الكلام بالصلاة.
And he also knows that speech in the prayer breaks his prayer and it's not allowed. He knows this.
متعمد.
And he does it on purpose, intentionally.
فالصلاة باطل.
So his prayer is invalid.
الثاني من مبطلات الصلاة الحركة الكثيرة. نعم.
The second invalidator of the prayer is a person who does a lot of frequent movements.
متتابعة متوالية.
And in succession.
عرفا يعني تراه تظن أنه غير مصلي من كثرة ما يتحرك.
To an extent that if another person was to see that person who is moving during the prayer, he would think that he isn't praying.
بدون حاجة.
And especially when there's no need for him to make those movements.
حركة.
So a movement.
كثيرة.
Which is a lot and frequent.
متتابعة.
And successive.
عرفا يعني تراه تظن انه غير مصلي.
Such that if it was seen by another person, he would think that this person isn't praying. So many movements.
لغير حاجة.
And there's no need or necessity for that person to make those movements.
يعني يخرج الجوال مثلا من جيبه ثم ينظر سبحان الله يقول من هذا ويفتح الجوال ثم ينظر في الرسائل ولعله يرد عليها ويقول انا اصلي. تنظر اليه تظن غير مصلي من كثرة ما يتحرك.
So like a person who gets out of his mobile phone, looks through his messages, maybe opens his phone, he might even answer and say, look, I'm praying right now, and then he puts it back down. So the person who is looking at him would not think that this person is praying.
نعم. الضحك.
Also, from the invalidators of the prayer is laughing.
الأكل والشرب.
Eating and drinking.
يعني يضع في هذا الجيب مثلا شيء من الطعام وفي هذا الجيب شيء من الشراب ويأكل ويشرب وهو يصلي.
So a person who's praying and yet he eats and drinks from his right and left pocket.
الانحراف الكثير عن القبلة.
Also from the invalidators of the prayer is a person who deviates away from the qibla by a large amount.
انتقاض الطهارة.
And also if a person breaks his purification.
يعني حصل له ناقض من نواقض الوضوء كخروج الريح مثلا.
So anything which invalidates a person's wudu, if it occurs in the prayer, then it invalidates his prayer, like the passing of wind.
لكن هذا لابد يكون عن يقين لا شك.
But this has to be based upon certainty and not a mere doubt.
لكن إذا جاء الشيطان وقال هل أنت متوضئ أم لا؟ فهو متوضئ لأنه عندما كبر كبر على طهارة.
But if Shaytan comes to a person and merely suggests to him or whispers to him to make him unsure of whether he is in a state of wudu or not, then he ignores the Shaytan. Why? Because when the person made takbir, then he was upon tahara, upon purity.
نعم. هذا والله أعلم يعني ما يتعلق بشيء مما يكون في الصلاة. يبقى معنا السجود السهو.
So this is what relates to the prayer. Everything we've covered over the last two or three lessons is what relates to the prayer. The thing which remains now is sujood as-sahu, the prostration which is made out of forgetfulness.
Sujood as-sahu, يعني السجود الذي يكون بسبب السهو للعمد.
So sujood as-sahu is the prostration which is done out of forgetfulness, meaning you have forgotten something and also you're making sujood as-sahu. So it's not for those things which you left out on purpose.
نعم. سجود السهو له أسباب ثلاثة.
There are three reasons or three main causes why a person has to make sujood as-sahu.
أن يزيد في الصلاة سهوا.
Either a person forgetfully increases something in the prayer.
أو يترك منها شيء.
Or forgetfully he leaves something from the prayer.
أو يشك.
Or he's in doubt.
إذن أسباب السهو ثلاثة.
So therefore, the causes or the reasons why a person has to make sujood as-sahu are three.
زيادة ونقص وشك.
Either an increase of something in the prayer, or taking something away from the prayer, or a doubt.
نتكلم عن الأول عن الزيادة في الصلاة.
So we're going to talk about the first one. If somebody does something extra in the prayer.
في صلاة الظهر مثلا قام للركعة الخامسة.
As an example, in the Dhuhr prayer, a person stands up for a fifth rak'ah, fifth unit of prayer.
متعمدا فالصلاة باطلة.
If he did this on purpose, then his prayer is invalid.
إذا قام للخامسة ناسيا فالصلاة صحيحة.
But if he stood up for the fifth rak'ah forgetfully, then his prayer is correct.
فماذا يصنع؟
However, what should he do?
مجرد ما يتذكر ويعرف أنه في الخامسة يقطع هذا ويرجع يجلس.
As soon as he realizes that this is his fifth unit of prayer, then he ends that fifth unit and he goes back down into the sitting position.
وعليه سجود السهو.
And then he makes sujood al-sahw.
الثاني النقص.
And as for a person who has taken something away from the prayer, is deficient in the prayer.
نعم. النقص عندنا إذا كان النقص والترك للأركان فالصلاة باطلة لا شك في بطلانها حتى يأتي بالركن الذي ترك.
So if the person who missed out this action in the prayer, if the action which he missed out from was from the arkan, from the pillars which we have mentioned, then his prayer is not accepted.
يعني مثلا ترك قراءة الفاتحة في الركعة الأولى.
As an example, in the first rak'ah he prayed, a person he didn't say Surah Al-Fatiha, he forgot to recite Surah Al-Fatiha.
وتيقن في الركعة الثانية أنه لم يقرأ الفاتحة في الأولى يقين 100%.
But when it came to the second rak'ah, then he remembered with absolute certainty, without any doubt, that he hasn't recited Surah Al-Fatiha in the first unit.
يرجع إلى هذا الموضع الذي ترك فيه الركن يعني الركعة الأولى عند قراءة الفاتحة يقرأ الفاتحة.
So he now has to assume the position in which he did not, in which he missed out that action. So he has to now assume that he has gone back to the first rak'ah in order to recite Surah Al-Fatiha.
ومن هنا يبدأ يستمر في الصلاة يعني يكمل الأولى ثم الثانية ثم الثالثة ثم الرابعة. كل شيء فعله بعد ترك الركن لاغي انتهى.
And then from this position, he commences the prayer. So if he went back to the first rak'ah to recite Surah Al-Fatiha, then the next rak'ah is going to be second and third. So anything which he has done after the leaving of the pillar or missing out the pillar, then this is not accepted.
إذن لو ترك ركن من الأركان لا تصح الصلاة، لا بد الاتيان بهذا الركن وبما بعد الركن.
So if a person missed out a ركن, a pillar from the pillars of the prayer, then anything after is not accepted. So he has to go back, repeat the rukun from that position, and then build on from there.
أما ترك واجب من الواجبات.
And as for a person who omits an obligation from the wajibat of the prayer, the obligations of the prayer.
إذا انتقل عن مكان هذا الواجب لا يرجع إليه وصلاته صحيحة ويسجد للسهو.
If a person he missed out an obligation of the prayer, but he's moved on now. He's moved on to another position. He doesn't need to come back to this position. His prayer is correct as long as he makes sujood al-sahw.
يعني نسي التشهد الأول وقام.
As an example, in the second unit, in the second rak'ah, a person forgot the tashahud and he stood up for the third rak'ah.
فماذا يصنع؟
What should he do?
التشهد الأول واجب من واجبات الصلاة.
Knowing that the first tashahud, it is an obligation from the obligations of the prayer.
هل انتقل من مكان هذا الواجب؟ نعم.
Has he moved on to another, to the next position? Yes, he has.
فلا يرجع ويجلس. يتم الثالثة ثم الرابعة ويسجد للسهو.
So as long as he has moved on to another position now, meaning he's now got up and he's gone on to his third rak'ah, then he doesn't need to go back to the second rak'ah. Rather, he completes his third rak'ah and he completes his fourth rak'ah and then he does sujood the sahu.
القسمة الثالث.
And then the third type,
الشك,
is a person who does sujood the sahu due to a doubt.
عندنا الشك إما أن يكون بعد الانتهاء والفراغ من العبادة أو داخل العبادة.
So this doubt which occurs, either it occurs after a person has completed the prayer and finished from the prayer, or it occurs during the prayer itself.
لا في كل العبادات في الصلاة وفي الطهارة وفي الوضوء وفي الاغتسال في كل العبادات ينقسم الشك إلى قسمين داخل العبادة وبعد الفراغ والانتهاء من العبادة حتى في الطواف وفي السعي.
In fact, in every type of worship, every type of ibadah, the same classification can apply. Either the doubt is in the middle of that which you are doing, whether it's tawaf, whether it's sa'i, whether it's ghusl or wudu or the prayer or tahara, or the doubt occurs after you have completed the act of worship, regardless of what the act of worship is.
Now,